Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Don't Starve. In the first episode, I did a bit of foraging and exploring, or as I call it, exploraging. Came up with a plan of attack. I remember there was quite a nice horde of beefalo in this area, which would be useful for their manure, for farming and so forth. I see there's quite a lot of berry bushes in this area. I want to make sure to get enough food before I travel on this episode, so I'm going to want to look around here. But what I like about this whole area as a whole is we've got a lot of wild grass resources. This looks like quite a forest up here, but there's also quite a few trees all scattered throughout. These particular biomes, the lighter green grass, are very good food resources. I can see, I have a feeling there'll be lots of berries. Also these bees, I'd like to start getting into bee boxes and so forth. But I'm getting ahead of myself. First and foremost, I have to set up an initial base of operations, as I talked about in the first episode. And I'm going to have to start working on my science tiers. So I'm going to start doing a little quick harvesting and talk about some things I didn't get to talk about last time or talk about as well as I'd like to. I looked back at the last video, and I felt I didn't do a very good job about describing certain aspects of the HUD and the game mechanics, so I'm going to talk about some of that stuff while we go here. First of all, science technology tiers. At the beginning of the game, you start out, I guess you could say, tier 0. You only have a certain limited number of things you're able to do. In fact, I'm still at tier 1, so I can just do like a quick review to show you here right now. Axe and a pickaxe. Can't even make a shovel, which is used for transporting transplanting resources. Hammers for transplanting structures and so forth. I can only make basic fires. I can make bird traps. And I can make a science machine, which is how I start advancing science. Now, there are three tiers of science. The first tier is with the science machine. That'll unlock some things, and then from a science machine you also have the ability to make the second tier, which is the alchemy engine, which allows you much greater range of higher technologies. And then finally the shadow manipulator, which is the third tier of technologies. So, now I know to do the things I needed to do or wanted to do that I was going to need a little bit more stone, wood, and gold. So while I'm talking about this, I'm just gathering up what I can. I'll make sure to grab any seeds and food that I see as well, because that's always an issue. I really do need at least one more gold nugget, because one thing I know, in order to get to the second tier of science right away, I will need a total of 7 gold nuggets. I was worried because of that bird egg that this guy was going to come running over, so we're just going to bail out of here on him. Ah, berry bush. And a spear. I like it. Can't complain about getting an early free spear for defense. Now, as I said, I'm going to go right through this dark area down towards over here. I'm looking just for berries and carrots to make sure that I've got enough food on hand until I get my farming operations going. Oops, I'm going down into a dead end there. So basically, you know, you start out, you're alone, you've just got a few basic tools, and all you can do is run around and do some real basic stuff that will keep you going, but not forever. The game gets progressively harder. It starts throwing waves of hell dogs at you every so many days. There's a winter season every 20 or so days. During the wintertime, most traditional means of farming and so forth dry up on you. So it's a challenging game. It may seem kind of peaceful and fun at the beginning here, but it progressively gets harder. I've seen videos of people who've gotten like 200 days into the game, and it's pretty impressive to do that, in my opinion. I don't want to run through here. It's getting late, as I feared. I think I'm going to worry about starting my base in the next day sometime. I wanted to have it going by this nightfall, but at the moment I still have other things I need to find. So we're just going to keep harvesting around while I talk about... Ah, there we go, some carrots and a berry bush. I'm going to keep pushing it until... that's another thing I should have talked about. In the upper right corner is like a clock here. This shows which day you're on, and the yellow portion of the day meter represents the daytime, obviously. And then the brownish-orange area we are in now represents dusk fall, which is it's a time that you are still safe-ish. Some creatures, like spiders, might be more aggressive. I'm not positive of that, but once it becomes fully nighttime, you need to have a fire or be sleeping in some kind of a tent or something, because there are creatures that will kill you. I forget what they're called. I think one of them is called the Gru or something like that, but it's bad news. You will definitely get killed. Is there any other food resources here? I guess I passed right through that area, but they all look like they've been picked clean. Probably, I believe that's where I started, if I remember correctly. Let's go ahead and set up just a temporary night camp here and cook some of this stuff. And then in the next day, I looked back at the last video, and in addition, like I said, of finding the buffalo herd up here, I remember seeing a lot of rabbit holes. I'm thinking about planning my first base somewhere in this area, near to these roads for travel. This peninsula is a little isolated for defense. It's surrounded by lots of natural grass, which will make it easier to harvest grass without having to keep relocating it, because then you have to fertilize it. And I'll have access to the beefalo and this other food biome. It's also not too far from the rocks, so I do believe that will be my priority. But right now, we're just going to get through the night. Oh, and I want to apologize for how long it took to get this second video out. I ran into some personal setbacks that I had to deal with. Nothing major. One of the things was I'm going to be doing things a different way now, using different software and different techniques that make things more efficient. And I kind of threw a monkey wrench into things at a time when I was trying to step up into like a phase two of new material. But it really had to be done, and it's going to ultimately make for me to be able to make better videos at a more consistent pace. And I do intend, when I pick this series back up here, to do them much more aggressively, at least a couple a week. I'm going to be maintaining two or three active series. And on the day you see this video, you'll probably see two or three of those new series launch at the same time. That is my goal, to make up for my week of absence by putting out a whole bunch of new stuff at once and then keeping up on them. So looking ahead to the next day here, I'm going to travel up into that area I mentioned, and I'm going to still need to worry about a little more food. I'm going to set some rabbit traps and get a base going, get the science going, get a log suit, and check to see where I stand on getting an alchemy engine up, because I would like to get the farming going as soon as possible, but I think I'm still going to be a little short on either wood or stone. In order to make an alchemy engine, you need like 4 wooden planks, and every 4 wooden planks is 4 logs. So that's 16 right there alone. And then a log suit is 8 logs. So that's 24 logs needed alone just for those two objectives. At a minimum, there's other things that need wood as well. And also, to make traps, I need grass and twigs, but the grass is also useful for some other things, including with making farms and stuff. So it's all a little... I'm going to really have to do a lot of gangbusters harvesting of resources here still. I'm really quickly going to take these two trees down on the way through and head right back up into that area. Oh, I do remember now. I wanted to say that because it took me so long to make this episode, I had said originally that I would do these as one for every 2 days of in-game time. This episode's going to be 3 days. I started it a little bit into the day, so there was some time lost there already. I'm going to play this one through until... normally, the end of this night going into day 5 would have been the end. I'm going to go all the way into day 6, or at the beginning of day 6. And also because I feel it's going to take me that long to get the final things together I want to do and get my farming operation running and so forth, so... I'm going to start heading back now towards the area I mentioned where I saw the rabbit holes, because I'd like to set up 3 or 4 traps and get them planted so I have food for later. I'm just taking a look here. Yes, I just got to come up a little bit and this way. Now, killing bunnies is considered a bad act. There is actually a little bit of like a karma moral system in the game. And when you do too many bad things over too short of a time, you spawn some kind of a creature. I believe he's called the Krampus. I'm not sure how hard he is to kill, but he's one of the bosses of the game. But you want to avoid him, so... While I do intend to live off bunnies pretty strongly, I want to be careful not to be just slaughtering them indiscriminately. Now this is the part I remember from looking back at the last video. I can see here that there's a nice row of like 4 rabbit holes in a row. That'll be perfect. So let's just go ahead and trap these right away. When you're placing a rabbit trap, you'll note you can't put it directly on the hole. You have to go a little above or below. I find below is the most efficient. Just line it up where you can't do it, go a little down, set the trap. That will put the trap in a position where it'll be pretty much guaranteed to catch something as soon as it comes in or out of the hole. So I'll throw down number 2. Number 3. And number 4. I don't want to be too far away from those because they are going to be my... I'm going to want to check those at least daily. They usually fill up pretty quickly. I'm just gathering grass, because just what I did alone used a lot. I know that for sure. And I'm going to need to make a lot of rope. The log suit and some of the other structures I have to make require rope. I'm really starting to feel like right around here, this open area is going to be a good place for a base. Gives me good access to the traps, not too far from the manure. But you don't want to be too close to the beefalo, because when they're in mating season, they can be very aggressive. I think I'm just going to go ahead right now. I like this nice open area here. I'm just going to go ahead and put down a fire pit. This is it's a permanent, longer-lasting fire structure. And there we go. Now we have that. First and foremost, I need to build a science machine. Science machine takes 4 wooden logs, 4 stone, and 1 piece of gold. And this is, as I said, going to allow me to start to advance my science. I'd like to show them to you in a certain order, but actually, first and foremost, I want to build the backpack because I'm almost out of room and it really would be helpful to me to move some things into a backpack here. I'm going to go ahead and plant a couple of trees around here too. Can always pick them down later. Okay, now, first of all, the things that I couldn't do before that are still grayed out, as you see it says Alchemy Engine 2 Prototype. You can't build those until you have the next tier of science, but I can build a shovel right away, and once this is prototyped, I will be able to make them indefinitely anywhere I want. You just need to be near the machine to build the prototype. And the shovel will allow me to transplant things like grass and twigs and so forth back to my base. Now for food, in order to build, there's 2 farms, the basic farm and the improved farm. The improved farm is faster, but as you see, I need an alchemy engine for that. Now I'm wondering right now if I take a look. I've got enough gold, it's just a matter of having enough wood and stone, so we're going to focus on that. Here we have a refine tab, and I can refine grass into rope, and wood into boards, and stone into cut stone. And it's the same principle here. Until it's been prototyped, I have to do it in the range of a machine. Now that I've prototyped them, I can make them indefinitely from anywhere. Now I need 3 more wood and 1 more stone. I'm not sure if I have enough resources for this, but we're going to try. No, I do not. I still need to cut down 1 more tree, unfortunately. So that'll have to wait until the next day. Put a log on here then in the meantime. I like to keep my finished resources in here. I generally like to keep like seeds and newer flint, rocks. These more used resources down here and the more rare stuff I like to keep in here. I'd also like to make a log suit and show you how I work with that, but again, that's also going to have to wait because we need more wood. Let's check to see if the traps have yet, luckily enough, spawned anything up because food is starting to hurt. Okay, they have not gone off yet, but I bet you by morning they'll all be full. I wish I would have had enough wood on hand to make the alchemy engine so I could start doing other things, but I don't think I had enough resources to do everything I wanted anyway, so before it gets fully dark here, I'm just going to harvest up some more grass from this immediate area. And then we'll just spend the night at the campfire here and hope that we have better food luck in the next day. I'm going to have to really prioritize on food. I can cook a few seeds. I don't want to use too many, but they do provide some sustenance. Okay, so while it's dark, let's just review some things. Luxury axe and opulent pickaxe. The nice thing about those are that you use gold nuggets. What you say, that seems more valuable, and in some games like Minecraft, gold tools are ineffectual. Well, these tools are just as effective, and flint is a non-renewable resource in this game, unfortunately. Whatever is available on the game world and in the immediate rocks is all you're ever going to get. Gold nuggets, on the other hand, if nothing else, there is a pig king. I believe earlier in the first video we had passed a house here which had a pig man in it. Well, if you can find the pig village, they have a pig king, and by feeding him different things, he will return certain amounts of gold nuggets. I shouldn't say feeding. A lot of them are like things you find in junkyards and stuff, or in graveyards. But basically it allows gold nuggets to be an endlessly recreatable resource. So that's why those are nice later. But in the meantime, I've got my basic three tools. I could also make a pitchfork and a razor right now. They're not as important initially. The pitchfork allows you to transplant ground around, and the razor is for cutting your beard, and there's some things like a meat effigy, which is a doll that helps protect you if you die, allows you to respawn. Useful, but not immediately important. In survival, a straw roll here is something I could make that I could have slept through the night, but it costs quite a lot of grass. It wasn't worth it. I just had to hunker down at the campfire. Oh, and there you go, day 5, and Wilson's epic beard has begun to grow. Also, day 5 is about the time that you can start getting attacked by hounds, so I have to be careful of that. Okay, still no movement on my food, so we're just going to run away from that. I'm going to head in this day all the way over here. We're going to run through, pick up whatever manure we can, and then gather food in that area. I also need to cut down a few more trees and probably transplant some twigs to bring back and get my base sort of up and running. I would like to have a nice selection of its own growing of grass and twigs and several farms in the long run, obviously, to make myself as self-sustaining as possible. I do apologize if I stutter or stammer at times. I'm still kind of new to this. I've had my channel for several months and put up 100 videos before this, but a lot of them were co-op, Left 4 Dead, and games like that where I had other people to talk to. And this has been a different experience, learning to play a game and still perform, think about all the things I want to do, but also talk and be entertaining. Not just rambling, but actually trying to be instructive and helpful and teaching something. I hope I will slowly get better at it, but, oh, interesting. Very interesting. This is a touchstone. That just guaranteed me one resurrection, thankfully. What I mean by that is, next time I die, I will appear at that spot. So that is a good thing. You'll note here that I am using a shovel on these saplings, and what I'm doing, therefore, is digging them up. I'm getting the twigs and the root sapling, and that'll allow me to replant the root sapling back at my base. I'm also happy to see all these berries and carrots, because I was worried about the food situation. I need to bring some stuff back with me. So we'll gather this together. I know I need another tree. Let's get that at least, if not two. Another thing about the shovel, you can start to dig up the tree stump after you cut down a tree, which allows that one extra piece of wood. Very useful. Like that. Plus, it doesn't leave unsightly tree stumps around. These days, I used to use the pine cones to feed fires. I usually just replant them right away. For one thing, it keeps the chances lower of getting attacked by the tree guardian. When you are constantly cutting trees down too much, there's a tree that'll come to life and attack you. And one way to thwart his attack is to start planting trees. That will settle him down, so... always trying to find some kind of a karmic balance in the game. Let's see, I think this is a full tree as well. Well, at least one more. Maybe two, because I need eight. I still have to make a log suit, and I don't know if I'm going to have eight yet here. I do, but just, so it would be a good idea still to cut one more down. I'm starting to wonder now if this would have been a better place for a base near this touchstone, because it is nice if you die to be able to be right in the heart of your base. But that touchstone will only work the one time, so... it's not like this is a terribly dangerous area to spawn in. Ah, carrot. Okay. I believe I've got enough stuff now. And it's getting late enough in the day that I'm going to start heading back to my base. And I guess it's time to first mention here that, oh my gosh, I'm not paying attention and I almost starved. I'm going to wonder how many people have been watching and screaming at the screen for 5-10 minutes. I was totally, again, you know, you get caught up in talking about what you want to talk about and thinking about the things you're doing. And I just lost track for a moment of where my food was, or my health. Well, my food, it's not my health. In fact, it's still quite critical, but I have a feeling I've got enough time here to get to my traps. I bet you they're all set. And I've got carrots to cook, so I'll be okay. I cut it close, that was very stupid and dangerous. But this will work out. We just gotta pick up and reset these traps. That'll get us 4 bunnies. So since we're winding down, there's certain things I wanted to say again. Again, I apologize it took so long to create this second episode. When I started this series, I had every intention and hope of doing it on a regular basis. But I had those setbacks and changes in the approach of things, and it's going to make a huge difference. It caused me to retool and redo a bunch of stuff that I didn't want to have to do, but ultimately it's going to allow me to produce multiple episodes a day, keep a large stock of pre-rendered footage available so I can go back and do things again if I need to for montage videos and stuff like that. It's all kind of rather boring and dry, I suppose. But it's interesting to me, and it was needed to be done. Now I'm going to real quick give you some more stuff here before we go out. The alchemy engine I need the one more board only for, so let's take care of that. Then I'll have my next tier of science before we go. Alchemy engine. There we go. Now, there we go. I can build an improved farm right away. So we're going to do that right away. We're going to put that over here. And when you build a farm, you have to plant a seed on it. Now, you can just wait for it to grow at that point, but if I go ahead and use, like, fertilizer, you see that it moved up a notch. And each one you do, you could grow it very quickly that way. But it's a little inefficient. I'm not, the food that I've recently eaten did get me back up out of a critical situation, so... I'm also going to go ahead here and start planting these before it gets too dark. I think I'll start over here. Will be a sapling farm in this particular area somewhere. Now by replanting these, they'll just grow here and I'll be able to quickly harvest them at the same time. They do not require, so far as I know, to be fertilized, unlike grass and berry bushes, so... And again, having so much natural grass in the air, I don't have to worry as much about grass. So I think that works pretty well for this area. A little worried about food still, so I'm going to just go a little further here. So a quick review for the wind down. I've got my 2 tiers of science machine available. I've already got a spear and a log suit. That's the most important. Oh, I didn't make my log suit yet, did I? Darn, I guess I didn't get to show you that yet. We'll have to do that in the next episode. There's not a lot else I could really build right now that would be worth building with the resources I have. The gunpowder comes into play later. I'm not sure what the nitrous for. Seeds for the farming and also for eating in emergencies. Manure for fertilizing farms and bushes and so forth, as I said. These for tools. I still need more rock and wood. Well, I guess that should just about do it. I would like to keep playing, and I may go ahead and continue the next episode right away, but for now I'm going to stop this video here. Again, I'd like to thank you for watching. I hope it's been more interesting. Things are going to ramp up and get more exciting in the coming days. The game will start throwing more and more challenges at me to kill me. I'm going to pause it here so not much more time is wasted. So, thanks for watching. I will shut over episode 3 up within the next few days and hope you're enjoying it. Please leave any feedback or questions you have in comments. If you have anything you'd like to see me do in the game, go ahead and post that and I'll do that as well. So thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next episode.